Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel, welcome to any new viewers. This is a reading for Libra, my beautiful Libras, Sun, Moon, Rising, Libra. This is all about how your person is feeling about you. So if there's a person you have in mind and you're wondering whether or not their deeper feelings are in line with how they're coming across or what they're showing you, then please keep on watching. We're also going to look at how they're viewing you, what they like, what they dislike about the connection or potential connection, and basically what their next moves are going to be as well, what they're planning. Of course, if you enjoy the reading, don't forget to like and subscribe. I really appreciate it. You can also feel free to check out your other placements or the sign of your person if you know what that is. Libra, let's see how your person is currently feeling about you, what is going on with them deep down. Let's work this out. Okay, and we'll just pull one more. And we have the Four of Water, which is the Four of Cups. Okay, very, very interesting here. Libra, okay. There's so much major arcana in this reading, which is telling me that this is quite a significant connection. This is something that, this person are going to really remember for a long time. It's going to really make an impact here, right? No matter what happens, no matter how long it lasts, when I see this sort of major arcana, it's like it's a real turning point. It's a real change. It's a real leveling up, I would say, as well. So as a result of this relationship or connection, you are going to, you know, gain something. It's going to be very significant for your learning, your development, your growth in your life, and vice versa for this person. Let's start at the beginning and let's have a look at how your person is currently seeing you. We have the Empress card here. This is really beautiful energy. This, of course, often represents Libra, also Taurus. This card is really suggesting to me that your person views you, again, male or female, doesn't matter, but views you as that very motherly type figure. And what I mean by that is that you are seen as such a beautiful person by your person. You're seen as someone who they can really build a future with, someone who is very valuable, someone who is very caring, someone who is, you know, really high value to the lives of others, to the people that you care about. The Empress is like all the queens of the tarot put together. So not only are you a very wise, intelligent, caring type of individual, they also look at you with a level of attraction as well, I have to say. So there's a strong level of physical attraction there too. But this is, it's such a beautiful energy that there may also be a feeling of, am I worthy enough? Am I good enough? Am I also at a level that Libra expects me to be at? Can I match this sort of standard that Libra wants or that Libra expects? So there is a question of that too. But this is certainly when we think about how someone presents themselves, how they come across. You also have a lot of grace, a lot of elegance. This person is really, really seeing you as a very well-established, classy individual, if that makes sense. And again, it sort of seems to me like they could be putting you on a little bit of a pedestal as well. But it really is beautiful energy to get. Certainly this person holds you in a very high esteem, sees you in a very good light. when we look at how they're coming across, how they're choosing to portray themselves to you, we have the sun. And this is very interesting. This could be Leo energy, so you could be dealing with a Leo. Doesn't necessarily have to be. They're really wanting to show you the best version of themselves. This person is wanting to come across like happy, positive, optimistic, everything's great. They feel like they need to do that in order to match your vibe, in order to match the type of energy that you give off, because they see that as so beautiful and radiant. They want to make sure that they can match that and that they can sort of stand up to what you give off, if that makes sense. They also want to prove themselves as someone who can help you grow. When we think about the Empress energy, it's all about growth for the future, abundance, like anything you touch kind of turns to gold. With the sun energy being so integral to a successful harvest, they want to almost provide the energy, provide the structure needed for you to blossom. They want to be seen as they are very supportive of you. They're supportive of your goals, of what you want to do for the future, your future plans, your desires. They want to be a part of that. They want to be very helpful with that. They also can sometimes come across as maybe a little bit of larger than life kind of ego that can happen as well, but probably more in a kind of fun way, I would say, rather than a serious like ego issue. I think they kind of portray that sort of arrogance as a funny thing, as a tool to make, again, people warm up to them or have a laugh, if that makes sense. So that is how your person is coming across. They also, when we see the sun, we see, you know, sometimes truths come out, or a light is shone on something, on an issue. So they may be wanting to be seen as very open, very honest, willing to talk about or discuss the things that need to be discussed. They don't want to be seen as though they're concealing anything. What's interesting about that is when we look deep down, we have the Five of Cups, and I'm really seeing that this person, whilst they are coming across as very, very confident, they want to have this high level of confidence, positivity, all that kind of stuff. Deep down, we have a couple of fears, and we have a couple of disappointments and sadness. It's being kept under wraps. They don't want to show you that. They don't want to show you what they're really feeling, but in some ways, there's a disappointment there. There's a sadness there. There's a fear of loss there. There's also a fear of rejection. That may be what drives this person to come across as so confident and so larger than life. It's really an insecurity. It's a fear of rejection. It's a fear of loss. This person is scared of losing you. They don't want to do something to ruin this connection or this chance they have to be with you. They don't want to do that. There could also be something going on elsewhere in this person's life that is making them feel, you know, quite upset, and it's taking them away emotionally from the connection a little bit. They can't help it. But really, there's something that is making this person a bit worried, a bit afraid, a bit upset, a bit scared about losing this completely. That's very interesting, because what they're trying to portray is very, very different to that. They don't want you to have any idea that's what's happening. We've got the World card here. This is all about, you know, new cycles, new beginnings. This person may be wanting to avoid a loss or a sadness or a disappointment because there was a previous loss in their life, a previous breakup or something that really affected this person very deeply. They're ready to turn over a new leaf. They're ready to start a new chapter. They want to do that with you. This is coming up as a positive in this reading. So what that means is sometimes the world can be, you know, an ending and a new beginning. It's like that sort of cycle of things, of, you know, one chapter ending and a new chapter starting. In this case, they want this to be a fresh start. If there was a disappointment, it is possible that this is someone you are reconciling with, or someone who wants to come back to you. It's possible that they just want to do it with a completely fresh start. They're seeing how much you actually mean to them, this connection means to them, and they want to start afresh anew. They want to also build a world with you, right? The Empress, the Sun, the world. This is all about creating something very abundant and beautiful for the future, building a very, very abundant life together. This is what this person wants. There could be something to do with your upbringing or your background being quite different to this person's. Perhaps you have lived in different country to them, for example. They like that about the connection as well. They like that sort of foreignness element. They like the blending of, you know, the two different backgrounds or the two cultures or whatever it may be. Nine of Cups is coming up here. This person is a little bit afraid of being used in some ways. This person is quite emotional, I have to say, deep down. There are emotions bubbling beneath the surface that they really do their best to conceal. But there are insecurities. There's fears of loss. There's fears of being used, or you not feeling the same way about them as they feel about you. There's fears of rejection. In some ways, this stops the person from moving forward in an efficient way. It makes them hold off. It makes them procrastinate because they are afraid of that rejection. So I have to say that despite how positive things are feeling, despite how they're coming across, they're not likely to make any big moves, any serious commitments, any serious displays of, you know, wanting to take things to the next level. They will kind of wait until they get a very clear signal from you. And I would say it has to be quite, it has to be very, very mutual. It has to feel like you are on the same page, but they will wait almost for your kind of signal before they do anything. They're going to keep busy. They're going to be doing things in their life that keep them busy, and almost wait for you to turn to them and tell them, okay, I'm ready now. I'm ready for this. Let's go. Let's do it. They are not going to take the initiative. They're not going to take the bull by the horns with regards to taking this relationship to the next level. They need clear guidance from you, or a clear signal from you, in order to do that. So it's very interesting, because you may not realize that because of how confident this person seems. It doesn't seem like they're the type of person that would need to wait for approval or to wait for the green light, but that's what's happening here. I'm going to leave it there, Libra. I hope you enjoyed that reading. If you did, don't forget to like and subscribe. I really appreciate it. Thank you so much for watching. I hope to see you all in the next video.